Thank you. Well, it's always great to follow a great leader, and you learn. Need to stand near the podium here because that's where the wireless is better. So I'll move over here to the left. Really want to talk a little bit about our path and sort of how we're going to begin to put in place structure, process, so that we achieve these good outcomes. And part of this is becoming a learning health system. So we learn from what we do to get better. And you've heard and seen before, we want to deliver exceptional clinical care. We want it to be efficient and affordable for our patients, safe and effective, and we have extraordinary engagement with our staff and our patients while carrying out our tripart mission as an academic medical center of education, research, and clinical care so that we get better and better over time. And you've probably heard this, this is sort of a famous quote now of every system is designed to get the results it gets. And processes so we get better results as we move forward. And you're seeing this. This right here, gap is a first step on this. Launch today, October 27th, of our inpatient dyads. The ambulatory dyads are going to be following in January so that we can achieve these goals of exceptional, safe, extraordinary, and efficient care. We began our process improvement training. More than 100 people have been trained across UK healthcare in the focus PDSA methodology. We are now engaging clinical teams. The dyads are being implemented. We're in quarter two right now. And we're going to be having focused improvement. Recall that each of the dyads was asked to establish their initial couple asking you to undertake a couple focused PDSA efforts. And then we're going to be working on developing. So hopefully by the end of this fiscal year, we'll have implemented change on all these units, both procedural and inpatient, and we'll have some model units that we're learning from as we're moving forward. Maybe I'm not close enough.
We think there's something wrong with the lab, so we're going to give you that one.
Good. Better? And as Mark emphasized, and Colleen has been saying for many years, we want to achieve every patient every time. And I think what this comes down to is that each of us feels ownership for delivering high quality care. And I've already heard that some of the administrative and clinical leaders are going around and asking people who's responsible for quality. And you're going to get a chance later on to tell us who that is. Because every one of us, especially those of you leading, have got to be quality champions as we're moving forward. What they didn't explain to me is how I advanced the slides with a bum hand, but I'll figure it out. There we go. This is another sort of famous quote you probably heard from Will Rogers. Even if you are on the right track, you will get run over if you just sit there. Simple interpretation of this. If you don't move forward, you're probably moving backward because every other academic medical center in the United States is trying to move forward. And so we need to, too, if we're going to continue to improve in comparison against the benchmarks. I love this quote from Steve Jobs. Probably like many of you in the audience, I've got an Apple product in my pocket. And he said, it does not make sense to hire smart people and then tell them what to do. We hire smart people to tell us what to do. And that's how I feel is we have an incredible number of smart people in this room who are becoming our dyad leaders to tell us what we need to do. It's the front line that really knows what's going on and can drive change. There we go. So then, who is in charge of quality? That sounds kind of tepid. Who's in charge of quality? There we go. I want to hear that again. Who's in charge of quality?
I am.
And that's what I think we need to be saying. And hopefully, by the end of this fiscal year, when you ask any of your staff who's in charge of quality, that's what they're going to say. I am.